back. So, willkommen zurück.
Let's open with a word of prayer.
Lasst uns mit Gebet anfangen.
Dear Heavenly Father,
lieber himmlischer Vater,
Lord, we thank you for this blessed day.
Herr, wir danken dir für diesen gesegneten Tag.
We thank you for all the truth that you impress upon our minds.
Wir danken dir für all die Wahrheit, die du als Eindruck auf unserem Verstand hinterlässt.
And all the points of contention that you agitate.
Und all die Streifpunkte, die du aufwühlen lässt.
To help us ensure that we stand on the right platform.
Die uns helfen, dass wir sicher sind, dass wir auf dem rechten Fundament stehen.
And I pray that you would continue to bless us now in this study.
Und ich bete, dass du fortwährend uns während diesem Studium weiterhin segnest.
And help us to see the wondrous things out of thy law.
Und dass du uns hilfst, die wunderbaren Sachen aus deinem Gesetz zu sehen.
And we ask all this in the name of Jesus.
Wir bitten all dies im Namen Jesu.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, so this is a sort of point that I want to, it's a principle, let's say this much.
So this is ein Prinzip, so viel sagen.
And it's in relation to Gog and Magog that we've been looking at.
Und das ist in Bezug auf Gog und Magog, die wir angeschaut haben.
Because this point will help us to understand other points.
Denn dieser Punkt wird uns dann helfen, anderen Punkten zu verstehen.
Okay, so it says in Ecclesiastes, there's a time for everything, right?
So in Prediger es sagt, es gibt eine Zeit für alles.
Amen.
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 Right. So. There's also a time to repent.
Es
right?
gibt auch eine Zeit, Buße zu tun.
Right?
Amen.
Okay, so in the Bible, every one of these waymarks, there's a different time comes, right?
So auf, in die Bibel, auf jeder von diesen Wegmarken ist eine bestimmte Zeit, der da ankommt.
Yes?
Amen.
So for it, just for instance, go to Ecclesiastes chapter 3.
So zum Beispiel gehen wir zu Prediger 3.
Vers 8.
Prediger 3 und Vers 8.
It says, a time to love and a time to hate. So, is there a time to hate?
So, gibt es eine Zeit zu hassen? Hate sin.
Okay, we should always hate sin. There's never a time where you shouldn't hate sin.
Immer die Sünde hassen. No, but when you see the sinfulness of sin.
No, no, no. Let the Bible explain itself. In the Bible, do we see there's a time to hate?
So in der Bibel sagen wir, dass es gibt eine Zeit zu hassen.
When you look at the Psalms, in one minute, all those men, they're pleading for the wicked, but then another, there's a point that they come to it, and now they say, curse them, Lord, punish them. And it's marking that their minds have now changed.
So right. In den Psalmen, man kann lesen, dass man für den Bösen betet und fleht, aber dann kommt ein Zeitpunkt an, wo sie dann sagen, also bestrafe sie, lass deinen Zorn über sie kommen. Also das markiert einen Punkt, wo es eine Wende gibt in ihrem Gedanken.
The Lord said, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated.
So, right? Der Herr sagt, Jakob habe ich geliebt, aber Esau habe ich gehasst.
So these are all prophetic markers, marking specific points in time, right?
So, dies hier sind alle prophetische Markierungen, die bestimmte Zeit markieren.
And it says, a time of war and a time of peace, right?
Zeit des Krieges, eine Zeit des Friedens.
Right? So, but this is a time of what?
So, dies hier ist eine Zeit des was?
What, this is a time of?
Trübsal, oder
Krieg. Time of?
Zeit des Friedens.
Right.
Zeit des Krieges wieder.
And it's telling us there's a time for everything under the heavens,
und
right?
Es sagt uns, es gibt eine Zeit für alles unter dem Himmel.
So we want to look at the time when you're to repent,
so,
right?
Wir wollen die Zeit anschauen, wenn du Buße tun sollst.
Okay, so go to Revelation chapter 2 and verse 20.
So in die Notizen, Offenbarung 2 und Vers 20.
Now this doesn't deny that when you're convicted of sin, you're to seek repentance, right?
Und das verleugnet nicht, dass wenn du von der Sünde überführt wirst, dass du nach Buße suchen sollst.
But this is a specific prophetic marker that's marking that right now is a time that everybody needs to repent.
Right? Aber dies spricht über eine spezifische prophetische Markierung, die markiert eine Zeit, wo jeder Buße tun muss.
Okay, so it says, notwithstanding, I have a few things against thee, because thou sufferest that woman Jezebel, which calleth herself a prophetess, to teach and to seduce my servants to commit fornication and to eat things sacrificed unto idols. And I gave her I gave her space to repent of her fornication, and she repented not. Behold, I will cast her into a bed, and them that commit adultery with her into great tribulation, except they repent of their deeds. Amen? Amen. So, we want to look at this time that she got, this space that she got to repent.
So, wir wollen diese Zeit anschauen, die ihr gegeben wurde, um Buße zu tun.
So, go to Revelation 17 and verse 1.
Offenbarung 17, Vers 1.
It says, there came one of the seven angels which had the seven vials and talked with me, saying unto me, come hither, I will show unto thee the judgment of the great whore that sitteth upon many waters. Who's this great whore?
Wer ist diese große Hure?
Jezebel, thank you. We didn't say anything else. Jezebel, that's who we're dealing with, right?
Jezebel.
And Jezebel ruled from 538 to 1798, right?
Jezebel hat geherrscht von 538 bis 1798.
And John is standing in 1798, right?
Und Johannes steht in 1798.
Okay, and it, because it says verse 2,
denn Vers 2 sagt,
with whom the kings of the earth have committed fornication, and the inhabitants of the earth have been made drunk with the wine of her fornication. So why is he getting shown the judgment?
So warum wird ihm das Gericht gezeigt?
What's she done?
Was hat sie getan?
She committed fornication with the kings of the earth from 538 to 1798, right?
Unzucht mit den Königen der Erden begann von 538 bis 1798.
So here we have 1260.
Right? Hier haben wir 1260.
And John is standing in 1798.
Und Johannes, der steht 1798.
The 1260 typifies the time period of the Sunday law, right?
So, die 1260 schattet die Zeitperiode des Sonntagsgesetzes voraus.
So, and go to Isaiah 23, which is another illustration of the same event.
Gehen wir zu Jesaja 23, jetzt wieder eine weitere Darstellung von dasselbe Ereignis prophetisch gesehen.
Verse 14.
Beginning Vers 14.
It says, howl, ye ships of Tarshish, for your strength is laid waste. And it shall come to pass in that day that Tyre shall be forgotten 70 years according to the days of one king. After the end of 70 years shall Tyre sing as a harlot. Take a harp, go about the city, thou harlot that has been forgotten. Make sweet melody, sing many songs that thou mayest be remembered. And it shall come to pass that after the end of 70 years that the Lord will visit Tyre, and she shall turn to her hire, and shall commit fornication with all the kingdoms of the world upon the face of the earth. Tyre is the papacy, right?
Tyrus ist der Papst.
She gets forgotten for 70 years, right?
70 Jahre lang vergessen.
The days of?
Die Tage von?
One king, right?
Ein König.
And at the end of those days, she's going to again sing like a harlot with all the kings on the face of the earth, right?
Ende von diesen Tagen, sie wird wieder singen wie eine Hure mit alle Könige auf dem Erdfläche.
So go back to Revelation 17.
So zurück zur Offenbarung 17.
Vers 10.
Und jetzt in Vers 10.
We're back here now.
Wir sind wieder hier.
And it says, and there are seven kings, and five are fallen. What is that?
So was ist das in Vers 10?
Five are fallen. I'm emphasizing something.
Fünf sind gefallen.
Okay.
This is the Vergangenheit.
Past tense, right?
Vergangenheitsrede.
And one is.
Und eine ist.
Which one is?
Welche ist?
On the board. Which one is? The one king, right?
Der ein König ist.
So the five are fallen. Babylon, Medo-Persia, Greece, Rome, pagan and papal, right?
Die fünf, die gefallen sind. Babylon, Medo-Persia, Griechenland, Rom, heidnisch und auch papstlich.
So, five
fallen.
So, fünf sind gefallen.
One is.
Einer ist.
And the other is not yet come, right?
Und das andere ist noch nicht gekommen.
And the beast that was.
Und der Tier, der war.
And is not.
Und ist nicht.
It says, the beast that was and is not, even he is the eighth, and is of the seven, and goeth into perdition. And the ten horns which thou sawest are ten kings, which have received no kingdom as yet, but receive power as kings 1 hour with the beast. That's after the 70 years, right?
So das ist nach die 70 Jahren in Vers 12.
At the end of the 70 years, she's going to sing like a harlot with those 10 kings,
so
right?
Am Ende von 70 Jahren wird sie wie eine Hure singen mit diesen 10 Königen hier.
These have one mind, and shall give their power and strength unto the beast. And the 10 horns which thou sawest upon the beast, these shall hate the whore, and shall... Okay, I jumped to verse 16.
So von Vers 13 sind wir zu Vers 16 gesprungen.
So this is a period from 13 to 16, right?
So das ist eine Periode von 13 bis 16.
Which would be from when she ascends, right?
So das wäre Anfang von wo sie heraufkommt.
Okay. It says, the ten horns which thou sawest upon the beast, these shall hate the whore, and shall make her desolate and naked, and shall eat her flesh and burn her with fire. For God hath put in their hearts to fulfill his will, and to agree and give their kingdom unto the beast, until the words of God shall be fulfilled. And the woman which thou sawest is that great city which reigneth over the kings of the earth. Right? So it's the woman and the kings, right?
Es ist die Frau und die Könige.
So it's this second period of 1260.
Es ist diese zweite 1260 Periode.
So the Lord said, right, he gave her space to repent. Where was that?
So der Herr hat gesagt, dass er sie Zeit gab, um Buße zu tun. Wo war das?
So, here, right?
So hier, diese 70 Jahre.
She gets punished here, but does the Lord destroy her?
Sie wird hier bestraft, aber hat der Herr sie zerstört?
No.
Nein.
Right? Still there, right?
Sind wir noch da.
Okay. So she gets forgotten for this period of 70 years, and it says period for her to repent,
so sie wird right? Vergessen für diese 70 Jahre, und das ist eine Periode, eine Zeitperiode, worin sie Buße tun könnte.
But does she repent?
Aber tut sie das?
It's like your children, right?
Es ist wie unsere Kinder.
They do something, you give them the hand according to the punishment, right? According to the crime.
Du, sie tun irgendetwas und du gibst ihnen Hand gemäß der Übertretung, die sie begangen haben.
And then they have time to think about it, right?
Und dann haben sie Zeit, darüber nachzudenken.
And if they repent, what will they not do?
Und wenn sie Buße tun, was werden sie nicht tun?
They'll not repeat it, right?
Sie werden es nicht wiederholen.
They'll take the punishment that you gave them with the love of the Father, and they will think, no, I will not dishonor my father or my mother, and I will not do this thing. Right?
So, sie werden die Strafe annehmen, die der Vater in Liebe gegeben hat, und dann werden sie denken, nein, ich werde meinen Vater oder meine Mutter nicht entehren, indem dass ich diese Sache wieder tun wird.
However, right?
Dennoch.
If the carnal mind is not changed, what will inevitably happen?
Wenn der fleischliche Gesinnung nicht verändert ist, was wird letztendlich passieren?
You will do the same again, right?
Die werden dasselbe wieder tun.
So if the punishment the punishment here was designed to bring her to repentance.
So right? Die Bestrafung hier war bestimmt, um sie zur Buße zu bringen.
And she repented not.
Und sie hat nicht Buße getan.
Okay, so we all see that illustration, right?
Das können wir alle sehen, richtig?
So this is a space to repent.
Das hier ist eine Zeit, um Buße zu tun.
And we can see she repents not, right?
Wir können sehen, dass sie eben nicht Buße tut.
Because she's going to come back and repeat it.
Weil sie kommt wieder und wiederholt die Sache.
So, now, we go to this illustration here.
Wenn wir zu dieser Darstellung hier kommen.
The seven trumpets are a parallel to the seven plagues.
Right? Die sieben Posaunen sind eine Parallel zu sieben Plagen.
It's the parallel to the 7,000 years.
Die wiederum eine Parallel zu die 7,000 Jahren sind.
So therefore, this point here is parallel to this point here.
So das Endpunkt von all die drei ist parallel zu dieser Endpunkt hier.
Right. When the angel of Revelation 18 comes down there, what does it typify?
So wenn der Engel von Offenbarung 18 hier herabkommt, was schattet es voraus?
Second coming, right?
Das zweite Kommen.
Okay, when Christ comes, right, where does he put the devil?
So wenn Christi kommt, wo oder was tut er mit dem Teufel?
Yeah, he puts them in the bottomless pit for 1,000 years, right? Yeah,
tut ihm in den Abgrund 1,000 Jahre lang.
So you have this 1,000 years, right?
Hier hat man den 1,000 Jahre.
Let's read.
Lass uns lesen.
This quote here.
Diese nächste Zitat.
It's just this principle, right?
Darin ist diesen Prinzip.
From Great Controversy 6:58.
Das ist von Großen Kampf 6:58.
It says the Revelator foretells the banishment of Satan and the condition of chaos and desolation to which the earth is to be reduced. And he declares that this condition will exist for 1,000 years, after presenting the scenes of the Lord's second coming and the destruction of the wicked, the prophecy continues. I saw an angel come down from heaven having the key of the bottomless pit. What comes down here?
Was kommt hier herab?
An angel, right?
Engel.
Okay, the angel of Revelation 18 comes down, right?
Der Engel von Offenbarung 18 kommt herab.
And he laid hold on the dragon, that old serpent, which is the devil and Satan, and bound him 1,000 years, and cast him into the bottomless pit, and shut him up, and set a seal upon him, that he should deceive the nations no more, till the 1,000 years should be fulfilled. And after that, he must be loosed a little season. That the expression, bottomless pit, represents the earth in a state of confusion and darkness, is evident from other scriptures concerning the condition of the earth. In the beginning, the Bible record says that it was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. Which point is this?
Welcher Punkt ist das hier?
In the beginning.
Thank you.
Am Anfang.
Right. And how else do we know that it's in the beginning? Another witness.
Woher wissen wir noch, dass das am Anfang ist? Ein weiteres Zeuge. Matthew 25.
John 1, right?
Johannes 1.
In the beginning was marking his baptism, right?
So am Anfang markiert seine Taufe.
And it marks the creation week, right?
Es markiert Schöpfungswoche.
7 days, right?
7 Tage.
And a day is as a?
Und ein Tag ist wie ein?
Year.
Ein Jahr.
And a day is also as a?
Und ein Jahr ist auch wie?
1,000 years.
1,000 Jahre.
Okay, right? So, the point is I want to make here, right? It says, so in the beginning, when the earth was dark and void, it's marking the point where Satan gets cast down to the earth, right?
So am Anfang, wo der Erde wüst und leer war, markiert der Punkt, wo Satan zur Erde geworfen wird.
Because Satan getting cast down to the earth is a parallel to the cross, right?
Weil Satan, der zur Erde geworfen wird, ist auch eine Parallele zum Kreuz.
So how is the earth?
So wie ist die Erde?
Dark and without void,
es
right?
Ist, dunkel und wüst und leer.
Right, and the Lord says, let there be light.
Und der Herr sagt, es werde Licht.
Right?
Amen.
Okay, so, and if we just read on, it says,
und wenn wir weiterlesen, es sagt,
the Hebrew word translated deep is rendered in the Septuagint Greek translation of the Hebrew Old Testament by the same word rendered bottomless pit. In Revelation 21-3, Genesis 1-2, prophecy teaches that it will be brought back partially, at least to this condition. So she parallels Revelation 20, that's marking the punishment upon Satan, right?
So sie erwähnt hier Offenbarung 20 und das markiert die Bestrafung auf Satan.
Okay, and she parallels it with the beginning.
Und sie stellt es parallel mit am Anfang.
Okay, prophecy teaches that we'll be brought back partially at least to this condition. Looking forward to the great day of God, the prophet Jeremiah declares, I beheld the earth, and lo, it was without form and void, and the heavens, and they had no light. I beheld the mountains, and lo, they trembled, and all the hills moved lightly. I beheld, and lo, there was no man, and all the birds of the heaven were fled. I beheld, and lo, the fruitful place was a wilderness, and all the cities thereof were broken down. And this is the 7th plague.
Die spricht über die 7. Plage.
So it's marking the seventh plague, the end of the 7,000 years, and the end of the seven trumpets. All the same point.
Es markiert der siebte Plage, der Ende von 7,000 Jahren und der Ende von sieben Posaunen. Derselbe Punkt. Eben.
The end here, right?
Hier, der Ende.
It is also therefore the beginning.
Und deswegen ist es auch gleich der Anfang.
Because at the end it's this place that's dark and wasted and void, and the Lord comes and says, "Let there be light." Right?
Am Ende ist es dieser Ort, der dunkel und wüst und leer ist, und kommt der Herr und sagt, es werde Licht.
Right?
Amen.
And we see, right? It's the end and the beginning. Right?
Es ist das Ende und Anfang.
Here is to be the home of Satan with his evil angels for 1,000 years. Limited to the earth, he will not have access to other worlds to tempt and annoy those who have never fallen. It is in this sense that he is bound. There are none remaining upon whom he can exercise his power. He is wholly cut off from the work of deception and ruin, which for so many centuries has been his sole delight. Okay, so it's a principle, right?
So this is that in principle.
Now, we will come back to this point in a minute. Next quote.
Also wir werden zu diesem Punkt zurückkommen gleich. Also zuerst zum nächsten Zitat.
I think it's just the next paragraph, yes.
Ich glaube, das ist der nächste Absatz.
It says, for 1,000 years, Satan will wander to and fro in the desolate earth to behold the results of his rebellion against the law of God. What will he do in that 1,000 years?
Was wird er während dieser 1,000 Jahren tun?
Yeah, okay, so what's he doing?
Er wird auf und
what's he going to do in that time?
Was wird er in dieser
what's
Zeit
it saying?
Tun? Was sagt es?
Okay, so he's got time to think about all the evil that he's done, right?
Zeit darüber nachzusinnen über alles Böse, was er verursacht hat.
He gave her space to repent.
Gott hat ihr Zeit gegeben, um Buße zu tun.
He gave her space to think about all the evils that she'd done through this time, right?
Er gab ihr Zeit, darüber nachzusinnen über all die Bösheit, die sie in dieser Zeit getan hat.
Okay. Did Pope John Paul confess that during those 1,260 years, what they did was wrong?
So hat Johannes der Zweite, der Papst, hat er bekannt, dass das, was sie getan haben, während dieser 1,260 Jahren, war falsch?
I'm sure just before he died, he said, yeah, what we did back then was wrong.
Ich bin sicher, dass kurz bevor er gestorben ist, hat er gesagt, ja, was wir damals getan hatten, war falsch.
Okay, so the point is that, you know, they are well aware of what they've done, and they've got time to think about it, right, before they do it again.
Sie sind wohl bewusst über was sie getan haben, und sie haben Zeit darüber nachzudenken. Time to think about it before what, sorry?
Before they do the same evil again.
Sie haben Zeit darüber nachzudenken, noch bevor sie es wiederholen.
So Satan gets time in this 1,000 years to wander to and fro and think about what he did, right?
So Satan hat Zeit während dieser 1,000 Jahren auf und ab zu gehen und darüber nachzusinnen, was er getan hat.
It says, during this time his sufferings are intense. Since his fall, his life of unceasing activity has banished reflection. But now he is deprived of his power and left to contemplate the part which he has acted since first he rebelled against the government of heaven, and to look forward with trembling and terror to the dreadful future when he must suffer for all the evil that he has done and be punished for the sins that he has caused to be committed. So did he repent in that reflection? Or should I say, will he repent in that reflection? So
würde er Buße tun in diesem Zeit des Nachsinns?
No, go to Nein. The next quote.
Nächster Zitat.
This is at the end of the 1,000 years.
Hier ist am Ende der 1,000 Jahre.
What does he do?
Was tut er?
Let's read.
Lesen wir.
At last the order to advance is given and the countless host moves on. An army such as was never summoned by earthly conquerors, such as the combined forces of all ages since war began on earth could never equal. Okay, this is Gog and Magog.
This
right?
is Gog and Magog.
Satan, the mightiest of warriors, leads the van, and his angels unite their forces for this final struggle. Kings and warriors are in his train, and the multitudes follow in vast companies, each under its appointed leader. With military precision, the serried ranks advance over the earth's broken and uneven surface to the city of God. By command of Jesus, the gates of the New Jerusalem are closed, and the armies of Satan surround the city and make ready for the onset. So what's he doing?
So was tut er?
It's repeating history, right?
So er wiederholt die Geschichte.
So the Lord gives him space to repent, and he repents not.
So der Herr gibt ihm Zeit, Buße zu tun, er tut's aber nicht.
Same principle.
Right? Selbe Prinzip.
Okay. Go. Go now to Matthew chapter 12.
Geht jetzt zu Matthäus 12.
In Vers 38.
Beginnen in Vers 38.
It says, then certain of the scribes and of the Pharisees answered, saying, Master, we would see a sign from thee. But he answered and said unto them, an evil and adulterous generation seeketh after a sign, and there shall no sign be given to it but the sign of the prophet Jonas. For as Jonas was 3 days and 3 nights in the whale's belly, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and 3 nights in the heart of the earth. Okay, so it says, the men of Nineveh shall rise in judgment with this generation and shall condemn it, because they repented at the preaching of Jonas. So the question is, right, and Christ says, a greater than Jonas is here, right?
Christus sagt, ein größerer als Jonas ist hier.
Okay, so where's Christ pointing back to?
So woraufhin weist Christus hier zurück?
To the baptism, right?
So, Taufe.
Where is it illustrated in the Bible, Christ coming out of the belly?
Und wo in der Bibel wird es dargestellt, dass Christus aus dem Bauch herauskommt?
Yes, go to Revelation 12, right?
Offenbarung 12, gehen wir dahin.
Vers 1.
Offenbarung 12 und Vers 1.
It says, there appeared a great wonder in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun and the moon under her feet, and upon her hand a crown of 12 stars. And she, being with child, cried, travailing in birth. What's she? She's travailing to do what?
Also, sie travailing. Sie ist im Wehen, um was zu tun.
And pain to be delivered. And there appeared another wonder in heaven. Behold, a great red dragon, having 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 crowns upon his head. And his tail drew the third part of the stars of heaven and did cast them to the earth.
That's right here, right? This is gerade hier in Vers 4.
And the dragon stood before the woman which was ready to be delivered, to devour a child as soon as it was born. And she brought forth a man-child who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron. And her child was caught up to God and to his throne. This is the cross, right?
This is this cross.
And the woman fled into the wilderness, where she hath a place prepared of God, that they should feed her there 1,260 days. We've been through this. At the time of peace, you have to flee, right?
Vers 6. Also das haben wir bedeckt. Und zur Zeit des Friedens sollst du flüchten.
And marks this 3.5 from here to the end, right?
Das markiert diese 3.5 von eben hier bis zum Ende.
Right?
Every four. Kann jeder folgen?
Okay. So, Christ began his public ministry at the first temple cleansing, right?
So Christi hat seinen öffentlichen Dienst bei den ersten Tempelreinigungen begann.
And he's saying that he's Jonah, right?
Er sagt, ich bin Jonas.
So Jonah comes out of the belly here, is filled with the Spirit, right?
Jonas kommt aus dem Bauch hier und ist mit dem Geist gefüllt.
The sign of Jonah,
das right? Zeichen Jonas.
Okay. And it says that the men of Nineveh shall rise up in judgment because they repented at the preaching of Jonah, right?
Es sagt, dass diese Männer von Nineveh werden in dem Gericht aufstehen, weil sie eben Buße getan haben, als Jonas zu ihnen predigte.
Okay, so go to Jonah chapter 3, verse 1.
Zu Jonas Kapitel 3, Vers 1.
These are all things we've looked at. I don't know how many times, I don't want to exaggerate, but many times, right?
Diese Sachen haben wir oft angeschaut.
Okay, verse 1.
Vers 1.
And the word of the Lord came unto Jonah the second time, saying, Arise, go unto Nineveh, that great city, and preach unto it the preaching that I bid thee. Who is Nineveh?
So, wer ist Nineveh? Ist Babylon.
That's not a correct, that's true, but it's not a precise application.
Also das ist zwar richtig, aber es ist nicht eine genaue Anwendung.
Okay, go to the book of Nahum.
So gehen wir zu das Buch Nahum.
Babylon is made up of three parts. Right?
Babylon is aus drei, steht aus drei Teilen.
And if we go to Nahum chapter 3,
and we go to Nahum Kapitel 3 again.
Just go to verse 7, so we see what it's talking about.
It's verse 7, and if we sehen kann, worüber es spricht.
And it shall come to pass that all that they that look upon thee shall flee from thee, say Nineveh is laid waste. So who's it speaking about? So
über wem spricht es?
Nineveh, right?
Nineveh.
So go to verse 1.
It's verse 1.
It says, woe to the bloody city, it is all full of lies and robbery. The prey departeth not, the noise of a whip, the noise of the rattling of the wheels and of the prancing horses and of the jumping chariots. Verse 4.
Verse 4.
Because of the multitude of the whoredoms of the well-favored harlot, the mistress of witchcrafts that selleth nations through her whoredoms and families through her witchcrafts. Who is Nineveh?
So where is Nineveh?
Right, the whore, right?
The whore.
But, I mean, Lucia's not wrong in the sense, but what I want to see is that it's representing a king with the woman on his mind, right?
Lucia ist nicht falsch in dem Sinne, dass es Babylon ist, aber hier stellt es ein König mit den, die Frau auf seinen Verstand.
Okay, but when you see here in this, in Jonah chapter 3,
aber in Jonas Kapitel 3,
let's read verse 2.
Verse 2.
Arise, go unto Nineveh, that great city, and preach unto it the preaching that I bid thee. So Jonah arose and went into Nineveh according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceeding great city of 3 days' journey. And Jonah began to enter into the city a day's journey, and he cried and said, yet 40 days, and Nineveh shall be overthrown. Right? So, when Christ, what's the word? When Christ gets baptized, where does he go?
So, wenn Christi getauft wird, wo geht er?
Into the wilderness for?
In der Wüste.
For 40 days, right?
40 Tage lang.
Okay, and it takes you down to the final test here, right?
Es bringt zum finalen Test hier hin.
Where Satan comes, right? And comes to deceive him. Right?
Satan kommt, um ihn zu verführen.
Right?
Amen.
So he's saying 40 days and then the seventh plague's coming. It's going to punish Nineveh. Right?
40 Tage, dann kommt die siebte Plage. Es wird Nineveh bestrafen.
Okay, and it says, verse 5.
Verse 5.
So the people of Nineveh believed God and proclaimed a fast and put on sackcloth from the greatest of them even to the least of them. So what's it showing us?
So was tut, was zeigt es uns hier?
Did the woman repent here?
So hat die Frau Buße getan hier?
No.
Nein.
She's on the mind of these kings right here, right?
Sie sitzt auf dem Verstand dieser Könige gerade hier.
But because of Jonah's preaching, many of them, including the king, will repent, right?
Aber wegen den Predigen von Jonas, viele von denen, der König inklusive, wird Buße tun.
Okay. So, it's teaching us a principle, right? That the woman, she's definitely not going to repent.
So, right? Das lehrt uns ein Prinzip, dass die Frau, sie wird keineswegs Buße tun.
But many who she's deceiving in Nineveh will repent, right?
Aber viele von denen, die sie in Nineveh verführt, wird wohl Buße tun.
Okay, because it says they proclaimed a fast, they put on sackcloth, and that's them now crying and sighing for deliverance, right?
Vers 5, wo sie diese Sacktuch anziehen, das ist gleich, wo sie klagen und rufen und klagen für Befreiung.
Okay, so go to Daniel chapter 4.
Gehen wir jetzt zu Daniel 4.
Now remember, Daniel chapter 4 is a parallel to Daniel chapter 2.
Und gedenke, dass Daniel 4 eine Parallel zu Daniel 2 sei.
Right, and it's marked by, let's just come down here. This point, right?
Das ist markiert von diesem Punkt hier.
Who's standing at this point?
Wer ist es, der an diesem Punkt steht?
In Daniel 4.
In Daniel 4.
Daniel's standing there, right?
Daniel steht da.
And he's going to tell Nebuchadnezzar who he is, right?
Und er wird Nebuchadnezzar erzählen, wer er ist.
And he's warning him about what's about to come here at the end, right?
Und er warnt ihn davor, was hier am Ende stattfinden wird.
Yes?
Amen.
Okay, so let's read this.
So lass uns dies lesen.
Verse 28.
Wir beginnen Vers 28.
It says, all this came upon the king Nebuchadnezzar at the end of 12 months. So what's this period of 12 months?
So wo ist diese Periode von 12 Monaten?
The seventh plague,
the
right?
The plague.
Okay, it says 1 year.
It's ein Jahr.
So he's standing there warning them, and he's telling them what's about to come, right?
Steht hier und warnt ihm und sagt ihm, was hier geschehen wird.
Okay, now, let's just, before we go any further.
So, noch bevor wir daran fort, weitergehen.
Here we have the seven plagues, which is the parallel here, right?
So hier haben wir die sieben Plagen, was eine Parallel ist hierzu.
So what's this seventh plague also parallel to?
So zu was ist diese siebte Plage auch parallel? So this trumpet.
Yes, what else?
Aber was noch?
The thousand years. The
thousand Jahre,
right? So what is it?
So was ist es?
It's a space to repent, right?
Es ist eine Zeit, Buße zu tun.
Is Nebuchadnezzar been given a space to repent?
So ist Nebuchadnezzar hier eine Zeit, Buße zu tun gegeben?
Yes, right. Let's read, right?
Ja, lass uns lesen.
At the end of 12 months, he walked in the palace of the kingdom of Babylon. The king spake and said, is not this great Babylon that I have built for the house of the kingdom by the might of my power and for the honor of my majesty? While the word was in the king's mouth, there fell a voice from heaven saying, O King Nebuchadnezzar, to thee it is spoken, the kingdom is departed from thee. And they shall drive thee from men, and thy dwelling shall be with the beasts of the field, and they shall make thee to eat grass as oxen. And seven times shall pass over thee, until thou know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men, and giveth it to whomsoever he will. The same hour was the thing fulfilled upon Nebuchadnezzar, and he was driven from men, and did eat grass as oxen, and his body was wet with the dew of heaven, till his hairs were grown like eagle's feathers, and his nails like bird's claws. And at the end of the days I, Nebuchadnezzar, lifted up mine eyes unto heaven, and mine understanding returned unto me, and I blessed the Most High, and I praised and honoured him that liveth for ever, whose dominion is an everlasting dominion, and his kingdom is from generation to generation. Okay, so verse 37, he says, now I, Nebuchadnezzar, praise and extol and honor the King of Heaven.
Vers 34 haben wir gelesen und in Vers 37 es sagt, jetzt ich, Nebuchadnezzar, lobe und erhöhe und ehre den König des Himmels.
So, did he repent in this time period?
So hat er Buße in dieser Zeit gemacht?
No, right?
Nein, hat er nicht.
So, the Lord brings him down and what does he now have?
So, der Herr bringt ihn hier und was hat er jetzt?
A space to repent,
eine
right?
Zeit, Buße zu tun.
He's not held guilty here because he doesn't really understand it. But this, when this comes upon him, now he's responsible, right?
So, er hält ihm in dieser Zeit nicht zur Rechenschaft, weil er versteht das nicht richtig. Aber hier, von hier an, jetzt ist er rechenschaftspflichtig.
Okay. Is there a space to repent in here for another group of people?
Gibt es eine Zeit, Buße zu tun für eine andere Gruppe von Menschen hierin?
The lost sheep, right?
Die verlorenen Schafen.
But if they don't receive it,
aber wenn sie es nicht erhalten,
it's done for them, right?
Es ist für sie vorüber hier.
Is there a space to repent in here?
Gibt es eine Zeit, Buße zu tun hierin?
Yes.
First group of people,
so für
right?
Die erste Gruppe.
You can see there's this principle all showing you that there's a space to repent for this people, space to repent for this people, and so on, right?
Es ist ein Prinzip. Da kannst du sehen, es gibt eine Zeit, Buße zu tun für diese Volk und dann eine Zeit, Buße zu tun für diese und für jene und so weiter.
It's a principle, right?
Es ist eben ein Prinzip.
And once they've had the light of heaven,
und nachdem sie den Licht des Himmels erhalten haben,
and they refuse to repent,
und sie weigern sich, Buße zu tun,
the door closes on them.
Schließt die Tür auf sie.
And this is what it's shown, right?
Und das ist es, was es hier zeigt.
Okay, so now I want to get this point. What passed over Nebuchadnezzar in this time?
So was ist über Nebuchadnezzar in dieser Zeit gekommen? 7 years.
Seven times passed over him.
Sieben Zeiten sind über ihn gegangen.
Right?
Amen.
And what is seven times?
Und was ist sieben Zeiten?
What does it mean, seven times?
Blessing or curse? Was ist sieben Sorgen? Was bedeutet
es? Not asking what it represents. I'm saying, what does it mean? Seven times.
Was bedeutet sieben Zeiten?
7 years,
sieben
right?
Jahre.
Okay, and so let me look at it this way, right? So a day equals a year, right? So
ein Tag ist gleich ein Jahr.
And a day also equals 1,000 years,
ein
right?
Tag ist gleich 1,000 Jahren.
So when we come here, Satan is cast down onto the earth. It's dark and without void.
So wenn wir hier ankommen, Satan wird zur Erde geworfen. Es ist wüst und leer.
The Lord says, let there be light in the beginning, right?
Er sagt am Anfang, es werde Licht.
And it's Jonah who's Christ coming, saying, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand, right?
Es ist Jonah, Christus, der kommt eben und sagt, tut Buße, denn die Königreich des Herrn ist bald da.
And they're given a space to repent so that they don't do the same thing again, right?
Sie werden eine Zeit, Buße zu tun, so dass sie dasselbe nicht wiederholen.
And the time, the space to repent is 7,000 years.
Und die Zeit, wo Buße getan werden konnte, ist 7,000 Jahre.
Right?
Amen.
Seven times.
Sieben Zeiten.
Satan is cast out of heaven here.
Satan ist aus dem Himmel hier geworfen.
What does he do at the end of the 7,000 years?
Was tut am Ende der 7,000 Jahre? Gathers the nations.
He surrounds Jerusalem. He does the same thing again.
Und singelt Jerusalem. Er tut dasselbe wieder.
Everybody sees this. The seven times here upon Nebuchadnezzar is a parallel to the 7,000 years from Satan is kicked out of heaven before he repeats the very same thing at the end.
Die 7,000 Jahren, die sieben Zeiten, die auf Nebuchadnezzar hier kommen, ist eine Parallel zu den 7,000 Jahren von Anbeginn der Schöpfung, wo Satan dasselbe wiederholt hier.
Just principle,
right? No principle.
I have a question.
Eine Frage.
Because I have this quote here.
Es gibt eine Zitat, die ich habe. Ich poste das jetzt in der Livestream-Gruppe.
Speaks about the punishment of Sodom and Gomorrah.
Das spricht über die Bestrafung über Sodom und Gomorra. Das Deutsche kommt jetzt.
Says here,
es sagt,
the secret of the Lord is with them that fear him. Abram had honored God, and the Lord honored him, taking him into his counsels and revealing to him his purposes. Shall I hide from Abram that thing which I do, saith the Lord? The cry of Sodom and Gomorrah is great, and because their sin is very grievous, I will go down now and see whether they have done altogether according to the cry of it, which has come unto me. And if not, I will know. God knew well the measure of Sodom's guilt, but he expressed himself after the manner of man, that the justice of his dealings might be understood. Before bringing judgment upon the transgressors, he would go himself to institute an examination of the cause. If they had not passed the limits of divine mercy, he would still grant them space for repentance.
Yes.
So, my question is now...
So, meine Frage wäre denn...
This space to repent...
Diese Zeit, Buße zu tun.
Would it be also including time until the final review, when the punishment is not executed?
Not for the woman, it's not.
Wird es denn beinhalten Zeit bis zum finale Untersuchung, wo die Frau...
You're not following the pattern.
Also nicht für die Frau.
I gave her space to repent, she repented not. She came and did the very same thing again.
Ich habe ihr Buße gegeben, eine Zeit lang Buße zu geben. Sie hat nicht Buße getan und sie kommt und macht dasselbe wieder.
There's no repentance for Babylon. Babylon is going to be destroyed. It's written.
Es gibt keine Buße für Babylon. Babylon wird zerstört. Yes, es steht geschrieben.
The principle is that the Lord always gives you space to repent until you transgress the limit of his...
Yes,
aber der Herr gibt dir Zeit, Buße zu tun, bis du den Level seines Vorenthalten überschritten hast.
So in the sense, the son-in-law... the Lord wants to pour the seven last plagues.
Yes. Right? But so am Sonntagsgesetz, der Herr möchte die sieben letzten Plagen ausgießen.
Then he extends basically the mercy still longer to.
Aber seine Gnade geht bis okay. Zum Ende. Seine Gnade. Gnade.
Okay, so you're saying, if I understand you rightly, that the space to repent would go also into here.
So wenn ich dich rechterweise verstehe, die Zeit Buße zu tun wäre sogar bis hierher lang geht.
I'd have to think about that, but the point is that
ich musste darüber nachdenken.
When she's brought, I mean, it says Satan in 1,000 years, which is parallel to this, is to contemplate on what he did, right? So,
die 1,000 Jahren, was eine Parallele ist hierzu, wurde Satan gegeben, um nachzusinnen über das, was getan hat.
Okay, let's go. What's the next point? Let's go to Daniel 5.
So, nächsten Punkt. Gehen wir zu Daniel 5.
Where does Daniel 5 begin? Lawrence can give us the answer.
Right? Wo fängt Daniel 5 an?
The second Sunday.
The second Sunday.
Zweite Sonntagsgesetz.
Because he's the grandson, or the son prophetically, of Nebuchadnezzar, right?
Weil der Enkel ist, oder der Sohn prophetisch gesehen ist von Nebuchadnezzar.
So he sets up the Sunday law here, and this marks the point where his father prophetically got punished, right?
So setzt den Sonntagsgesetz hier auf, und dieser Punkt markiert der Punkt prophetisch gesehen, wo sein Vater Nebuchadnezzar bestraft würde.
Okay, so you'd have to show me where Belshazzar gets space to repent in here.
Da musstest du mir denn zeigen, wo Belshazzar in dieser Zeit hat Buße zu tun.
Because remember, the principle in the Bible is that when, like for us, she says the accumulation of the whole Bible is there, so that we don't make the same mistakes that they made, right?
Für uns, Ellen White sagt, die Gesamtheit der Bibel ist eben da für uns, damit wir nicht denselben Fehlern wiederholen, die sie getan haben.
Okay, just before we go, I'm sure there's some points we look at, but just go to Daniel 5, verse 18.
So, geht zuerst zu Daniel 5, Vers 18.
Because when Belshazzar begins this thing, he brings in these cups and they start drinking, and immediately the hand comes and writes on the wall, many, many tekelu phasen.
Right? Sofort, dass Belshazzar diesen Kelchen hineinbringt und die fangen an zu trinken, kommt diese Hand und fängt an, many, many tekelu phasen zu schreiben.
Okay, so maybe, unless we've understood it wrong, maybe that's later on in the Sunday law.
Okay. So, es sei denn, dass wir dies falsch verstanden haben, das ist später im Sonntagsgesetz.
The last time we laid this out was they start drinking at the Sunday law.
So das letzte Mal, dass wir das ausgelegt haben, sie fangen an, am Sonntagsgesetz zu trinken.
Then at the midnight cry, they command to bring these vessels.
Aber dann am Mitternachtsruf geben die den Befehl, diesen Kelchen hineinzubringen.
And then they drink from the vessels and they praise the gods of gold, silver and so on.
Dann trinken sie von den Gefäßen und loben den Götzen von Gold und Silber und so weiter.
And this is a parallel to Revelation 9.
Das wäre eine Parallele zur Offenbarung 9.
To the sixth trumpet.
Bis zu der sechste Posaune.
Because then basically the Lord brings the sixth trumpet upon them to bring them to repentance, but it says neither repented they of the murderers, nor of the sorceries, nor of the fornication, nor of the theft.
Der Herr hat die sechste Posaune auf sie gebracht, um sie von ihrem Werken Buße zu tun, aber es sagt, weder haben sie von ihren Dieben und Mörden und so weiter Buße getan.
And then basically the finger comes to judgment.
Und dann kommt das Finger, um Gericht auszusprechen.
Okay, I will have a look at this a bit closer, but I'm just comparing, when you compare the 1,000 years, you also compare Nebuchadnezzar.
Also wenn du den 1,000 Jahren vergleichst, du vergleichst auch Nebuchadnezzar.
What did Nebuchadnezzar do in those 7 times?
Was tat Nebuchadnezzar in diesen 7 Zeiten?
Yeah, he repented. And
tat Buße.
Satan didn't repent.
Satan tat nicht Buße.
Okay, and the woman doesn't repent.
Die Frau tut nicht Buße.
Okay, so there's definitely something to that, but I'm open to see, maybe there still is some a little time there, but let's see what happened to Belshazzar.
Also ich bin dazu offen, vielleicht gibt es noch Zeit da, aber lass uns zuerst schauen, was mit Nebuchadnezzar, Belshazzar geschah.
And the other point that I want to make is that clearly you can see where you've got the 1,000 years here also, is also a time to repent.
Und was ich auch möchte, dass wir sehen, es ist klar hier, diese 1,000 Jahre, die hier markiert, ist auch eine Zeit, um Buße zu tun.
So you have these two witnesses marking this time. So
diese zwei Zeugen, die diese Zeit hier markiert.
Okay. So, Vers 18.
Vers 18.
O thou King, the Most High God gave Nebuchadnezzar thy father a kingdom, and majesty, and glory, and honor. And for the majesty that he gave him, all people, nations, and languages trembled and feared before him. whom he would he slew, and whom he would he kept alive, and whom he would he set up, and whom he would he put down. But when his heart was lifted up, and his mind hardened in pride, he was deposed from his kingly throne, and they took his glory from him. And he was driven from the sons of men, and his heart was made like the beasts, and his dwelling was with the wild asses. They fed him with the grass like oxen, and his body was wet with the dew of heaven, till he knew that the Most High God ruled in the kingdom of men, and that he appointeth over it whomsoever he will. And thou, his son, O Belshazzar, hast not humbled thine heart, though thou knewest all this, but hast lifted up thyself against the Lord of heaven. And they have brought the vessels of his house before thee, and thou and thy lords, thy wives, and thy concubines have drunk wine in them, and hast praised the gods of silver and gold, of brass, iron, wood, and stone, which see not, nor hear, nor know, and the God in whose hand thy breath is, and whose are all thy ways, hast thou not glorified. Then was the part of the hand sent from him, and this writing was written. And this is the writing that was written: Many, many Tekel Upharsin. This is the interpretation of the thing: Many, God hath numbered thy kingdom and finished it. Tekel, thou art weighed in the balances and found wanting. Peres, thy kingdom is divided and given to the Medes and Persians. Then commanded Belshazzar, and they clothed Daniel with scarlet and put a chain of gold around his neck and made a proclamation concerning him that he should be the third ruler in the kingdom. Okay, so Daniel would be standing here, just like he was standing here for Nebuchadnezzar. Right?
Daniel würde dann an diesem Punkt stehen, genauso wie an diesem Punkt gestanden hat für Nebuchadnezzar.
Okay, so in that night was Belshazzar the king of the Chaldeans slain.
Vers 30.
Okay. Okay, so I'm open to that, but we have to marry up all these other things also.
Ich bin dazu offen, aber all diese andere Sachen müssen wir auch.
Now, you also have this other point. Go to Luke chapter 13.
Gibt's ein weiteres Punkt, gehen wir zu Lukas 13.
Now remember, you got this 1 year here, which is also this 1,000 years, right?
So, gedenke, dass es dieses ein Jahr hier gibt, was auch gleich diese 1,000 Jahre ist.
And in Luke 13,
und in Lukas 13,
verse 1,
Vers 1,
it says, there were present at that season some that told him of the Galileans whose blood Pilate had mingled with their sacrifices. And Jesus answering said unto them, suppose ye that these Galileans were sinners above all the Galileans because they suffered such things? I tell you, nay, but except ye repent, ye shall all likewise perish. Or those 18 upon whom the tower in Siloam fell and slew them, think ye that they were sinners above all men that dwelt in Jerusalem? I tell you, nay, but except ye repent, ye shall all likewise perish. He speak, now he's going to explain this, right?
So, jetzt in Vers 6 wird dies erklären.
Because he points them back to these two incidents.
Und weist zurück auf diese zwei Ereignissen.
And he says, unless you repent. So he gives them now a space to repent, right?
Er sagt, es sei denn, dass ihr Buße tut. Also er gibt ihnen dementsprechend eine Zeit, Buße zu tun.
And he explains it, right?
Jetzt erklärt das in Vers 6.
It says, then said he unto the dresser of this vineyard, behold, these 3 years...
Mr. Vers 6.
Okay, he spake also this parable. A certain man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard, and he came and sought fruit thereon, and found none. Then said he unto the dresser of this vineyard, behold, these 3 years I come seeking fruit on this fig tree, and find none. Cut it down. Why cumbereth it the ground? And he answering said unto him, Lord, let it alone this year also, till I shall dig about it and dung it. And if it bear fruit, well, and if not, then after that thou shalt cut it down. So when was he to cut it down?
So wann sollte es abhauen?
At the end of the year.
So am Ende des Jahres.
And what happened to Nebuchadnezzar at the end of the year?
Was geschah mit Nebuchadnezzar am Ende des Jahres?
He got cut down.
Er ist abgehauen.
And remember, this cutting down here is typifying the execution of the judgment, right?
Und ich denke, dass dieses Abhauen hier schattet diese Ausführung des Gerichtes voraus.
So this is why I'm saying this point, that although the woman, she got her space to repent, she doesn't repent, the repentance time period in here would be for others, not necessarily for those that didn't repent, if you get my meaning.
No, sorry, missed me there. Say that again.
Although there might be space to repent in here, it's not for those here that were already given space to repent.
So, obwohl es vielleicht möglich Zeit hier drin gibt für einige Buße zu tun, ist es nichts für diejenigen in dieser Zeit, die Zeit gegeben werden, zu Buße zu tun und nichts tat.
Like, for instance, at the cross, right?
Zum Beispiel am Kreuz.
Should Jerusalem's probation closed?
So, Jerusalem sein Gnade schließte.
But what did the Lord do?
Aber was tat der Herr?
In fact, years. Yeah, he says he extended the period for 40 years, right?
Er hat die Zeit ihrer Gnade 40 Jahre lang erweitert.
Okay, there's still verlängert. All many people, Jews, the young people had never really heard the truth that Jesus had taught, right?
Es gab viele von den Juden, besonders den Jungen, die noch nie eine Gelegenheit hatte, die Wahrheiten zu hören, die Jesus lehrte.
So he walked out of that temple and said, "Your house is left unto you desolate." Their probation had closed.
So er ist aus diesem Tempel herausgegangen und gesagt, euer Haus ist euch wüst hinterlassen. Deren Gnadetür ist zugegangen.
But the punishment upon them tarried.
Aber die Bestrafung auf sie verzögerte.
Because there was other people that needed to hear. Right?
Weil es gab anderen, die die Wahrheit noch hören mussten.
So though I agree with his point that there's maybe a period of probation, it's not because I don't believe it's because Belshazzar had any more probation.
So, obwohl ich vielleicht zustimme mit Bruder Lorenzes Punkt, dass es vielleicht noch Gnade gibt, ich stimme nicht zu, dass es für Belshazzar war. Did I say that right?
No.
What did you say?
I says I don't believe that it was for Belshazzar.
No, I did say it right.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Sorry, I didn't say it right.
But it's caught your face. So.
Right. There's space for other people.
Es gibt Zeit für anderen.
It's the same as like probation closes for a group of people here, right?
Sagt auch, dass die Gnade für eine Gruppe von Menschen hier schließt.
But it's still open for another group here.
Aber es ist immer noch offen für eine andere Gruppe hier.
Okay.
Amen.
So, got to look at. It's all dependent upon whether or not they've had the light of heaven and the greatest evidence given to them.
Es hängt davon ab, ob sie den Licht des Himmels und den größten Beweis erhalten haben.
Okay, so I don't know that it's as straightforward as it looks, but definitely in Luke 13 gives you this key. At the end of the year, if they've not repented, they're cut down, right?
So ich bin mir nicht so sicher, ob das so schlicht einfach ist, wie es sich scheint, aber auf jeden Fall in Lukas 13 ist der Schlüssel da, dass am Ende des Jahres, wenn sie nicht Buße getan haben, werden sie abgehauen.
And Nebuchadnezzar's cut down was just typifying it because he was not as guilty, he didn't understand things as much as Belshazzar did, right?
Und Nebuchadnezzars Abhauen sein, das war nur eine Vorausschattung, weil er war nicht so schuldig wie Belshazzar zum Beispiel.
Okay, so let's now go to the next heading, the Revelation.
Gehen wir zum nächsten Überschrift, die Offenbarung.
Because when, I mean, what it does by with Satan, it shows us, right, that he got cast out of heaven in the beginning.
So Satan, der ist aus dem Himmel hinausgeworfen worden am Anfang.
He got this whole 7,000 years. To repent.
Diese gesamten 7000 Jahre, um Buße zu tun.
And there's many times through that 7000 years that illustrates the close of probation, right?
Es gibt viele Zeiten während diese 7000 Jahren, die markiert Schluss der Gnadenzeit,
right? And then at the end of the 1000 years, right, he still doesn't repent.
Und am Ende von den 1000 Jahren tut er immer noch nicht Buße.
And it's just showing you that, look, because let's go. Now Christ is going to illustrate the revelation, even after the end of the 1000 years.
So jetzt wird Christus die Offenbarung darstellen, selbst nach Ende der 1000 Jahre.
And he's just proven a point, right? That all of them, none of them are going to repent, right?
Und er macht nur einen Punkt klar, dass alle von sie, keine von denen, werden Buße tun.
Okay, and it's great controversy 665.
Und das ist ein großer Kampf 665.
Now this is at the end of the 1000 years, when he appears at the top of the city.
Das ist am Ende von 1000 Jahren, wo er erscheint, oben auf der Stadt.
It says, now Christ again appears to the view of his enemies, far above the city, upon a foundation of burnished gold, is a throne high and lifted up. What's it a representation of?
So was steht das da?
The cross, right?
Das Kreuz.
It's the revelation.
Das ist die Offenbarung.
Upon his throne sits the Son of God, and around him are the subjects of his kingdom. The power and majesty of Christ no language can describe, no pen portray. The glory of the eternal Father is enshrouding his Son. The brightness of his presence fills the city of God and flows out beyond the gates, flooding the whole earth with its radiance. What is this?
So was ist das hier?
The whole earth is what?
Die gesamte Erde ist was?
Full of his glory.
Voll der Herrlichkeit.
What are they all seeing?
Was sehen sie alle?
Revelation.
Yes, but they're seeing the, okay, it's true. They're seeing the same as what Isaiah saw, right?
Sie sehen dasselbe wie das, was Jesaja sah.
Holy, 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 the whole earth is full of his glory.
Heilig, right? Heilig, heilig, die ganze Erde ist voll seiner Herrlichkeit.
And it says, next quote,
und nächste Zitat sagt,
we need to study the pouring out of the seventh vial. The powers of evil will not yield up the conflict without a struggle. And this is what we see here, right?
So, das ist, was wir hier sehen.
But providence has a part to act in the battle of Armageddon, when the earth is lightened with the glory of the angel of Revelation 18. Right? So this is how we see the end of the 7,000 years. It's a parallel to the seventh plague. Right?
So das Ende von den 7,000 Jahren ist es eine Parallel zu das Ende von siebten Plage.
Because when Christ comes, he comes in the glory of the Father. Right?
Denn wenn Christi kommt, er kommt in der Herrlichkeit seines Vaters.
The whole earth is full of his glory, right?
Die Erde ist voll seiner Herrlichkeit.
So, go to the next quote, which is the quote that we're just continuing with.
So, gehen wir zum nächsten Zitat. Fahren wir damit fort.
Above the throne is revealed the cross, and like a panoramic view appear the scenes of Adam's temptation and fall, and the successive steps in the great plan of redemption. The Savior's lowly birth, his early life of simplicity and obedience, his baptism in Jordan, the fast and temptation in the wilderness, his public ministry, unfolding to men heaven's most precious blessings, the days crowded with deeds of love and mercy, the nights of prayer and watching in the solitude of the mountains, the plottings of envy, hate and malice which repaid his benefits, the awful mysterious agony in Gethsemane beneath the crushing weight of the sins of the whole world, his betrayal into the hands of the murderous mob, the fearful events of that night of horror, the unresisting prisoner, forsaken by his best-loved disciples, rudely hurried through the streets of Jerusalem, the Son of God exultingly displayed before Annas, arraigned in the high priest's palace in the judgment hall of Pilate, before the cowardly and cruel Herod, mocked, insulted, tortured, and condemned to die, all are vividly portrayed. So, at the end of the 1,000 years, Satan surrounds Jerusalem, right?
So am Ende von 1,000 Jahren, Satan umzingelt Jerusalem.
Then he begins to muster his forces, right?
Dann fängt er an, seine Heere zu sammeln.
And he comes up again at this point and he surrounds Jerusalem, right?
Und er kommt wieder an diesen Punkt und belagert Jerusalem.
Right, because here is actually marking the resurrection, but this would be the actual point that he surrounds Jerusalem.
Hier markiert der Auferstehung, aber dies wird der Punkt markieren, wo er Jerusalem belagert.
And we know that what does the Lord do at the beginning of the seventh plague to the threefold union?
Und was ist es, was der Herr zu den dreifaltigen Union macht am Anfang der siebte Plage?
He stops them right in their track, right? Er
stoppt sie auf ihrem Bahn.
So when they come up to surround Jerusalem, Christ reveals himself and they're all stopped in their track, right?
So wenn er kommt, um Jerusalem zu belagern, der Herr offenbart sich und sie werden alle in ihrem Bahn gestoppt.
And he shows them now the revelation, right?
Er zeigt sie die Offenbarung,
right? And that's happening all down through this period, right?
Und das geschieht diese ganze Zeitperiode hindurch hier.
The seventh plague is the angel of Revelation 18, right?
So, der siebte Plage ist die Engel von Offenbarung 18.
Okay, so let's continue on.
Sonst weiterlesen.
It says, and now before the swaying multitude are revealed the final scenes. The patient sufferer treading the path to Calvary, the Prince of Heaven hanging upon the cross, the haughty priests and the jeering rabble deriding his expiring agony, the supernatural darkness, the heaven, the heaving earth, the rent rocks, the open graves, marking the moment when the world's Redeemer yielded up his life. The awful spectacle appears just as it was. Satan, his angels, and his subjects have no power to turn from the picture of their own work. Each actor recalls the part which he performed. Herod, who slew the innocent children of Bethlehem that he might destroy the king of Israel. The base Herodias, upon whose guilty soul rests the blood of John the Baptist. The weak, time-serving Pilate, the mocking soldiers, the priests and rulers, and the maddened throng who cried, "His blood be on us and on our children." All behold the enormity of their guilt. They vainly seek to hide from the divine majesty of his countenance, outshining the glory of the sun. So what's he revealing to them?
So was offenbart sie? Was offenbart
er? It's the exceeding bright light, right?
Ist das äußerst helles Licht, richtig?
Right. And what's he trying to what's he trying to get them to do?
So was versucht er zu das er zu, sie zu was versucht er sie zu bringen?
To repent, right?
Buße zu tun.
He's revealing this glory to them to bring them to repentance.
Er offenbart diese Herrlichkeit zu sie, um sie zur Buße zu führen.
He knows they won't repent, but he's just showing this point that why he's just, because he's showing that with this spirit they will never repent, right?
Er weiß, dass sie nicht Buße tun wird, aber er beweist seine Gerechtigkeit, weil mit diesem Geist werden sie nie Buße tun.
Okay. Last paragraph, yes.
So, letzter Absatz.
Notwithstanding that Satan has been constrained to acknowledge God's justice and to bow to the supremacy of Christ, his character remains unchanged. The spirit of rebellion, like a mighty torrent, again bursts forth. So what does he do?
So was tut er?
He repented not, right?
Er tat nicht Buße.
I'm just trying to show that because this would be this period where they're trying to bring them to repentance.
Das wäre diese Periode hier, wo sie versuchen, sie zur Buße zu bringen.
The Lord just shown the same repeating patterns, right?
Der Herr zeigt nur diese wiederholende Muster.
It says, filled with frenzy, he determines not to yield the great controversy. The time has come for a last desperate struggle against the King of Heaven. He rushes into the midst of his subjects and endeavors to inspire them with his own fury and arouse them to instant battle. But of all the countless millions whom he has allured into rebellion, there are none now to acknowledge his supremacy. His power is at an end. The wicked are filled with the same hatred of God that inspires Satan. What character do they have?
So, welche Charakter haben sie?
Ye are of your father the devil, right?
Ihr seid von eurem Vater, dem Teufel.
But they see that their case is hopeless, that they cannot prevail against Jehovah. Their rage is kindled against Satan and those who have been his agents in deception, and with the fury of demons they turn upon them. Kingdom against kingdom.
So, Königreich gegen
brother against brother.
Bruder, right? Gegen Bruder.
Okay. So, now, you'll see why this is more relevant when we come back to,
Thursday.
On Thursday, we'll continue with Gog and Magog.
Ihr werdet sehen, warum dies von Bedeutung ist, wenn wir Donnerstag wiederkommen. Wir werden mit Gog und Magog fortsetzen.
Because the point is, I want to show that Gog and Magog in chapter 38 and 39 is an illustration of the first Sunday law.
Denn ich möchte zeigen, dass Gog und Magog, Ezekiel 39,
yes.
Das in Hezekiel 38 und 39 ist eine Darstellung von dem Sonntagsgesetz.
Okay, and it's typifying here.
Und es schattet hier.
What happens in Revelation 20 at the end?
Es schattet hier voraus, was hier in Offenbarung 20, was am Ende stattfindet.
They're given a space to repent.
Right? Sie werden eine Zeit gegeben, um Buße zu tun.
Now, the conclusion is, this is our line, right?
Die Schlussfolgerung ist, dass dieses unsere Linie.
Okay, so, the our line actually would, if you were to, it doesn't matter, I'm not going to go into it, right? It's... The point is, it's a smaller fractal, but it's the same pattern, right?
Also, der Prinzip ist, es ist eine kleinere Fraktal, derselbe Muster.
Now, I could write 1 to 5, 6 and 7, 1 to 5, 6 and 7. It would just be on a smaller level.
So, right? Ich konnte hier 1 bis 5, 6, 7, 1 bis 5, 6, 7. Es wäre dasselbe, nur auf eine weiter kleinere Ebene.
But we're here, right? You have a type of this seventh plague, right?
Wir sind aber hier, ein Typus für diese siebte Plage hier.
And the punishment here is a type of the punishment that comes on Gog and Magog here.
Und der Bestrafung hier, dieser Punkt hier, seine Bestrafung, ein Typus für die Bestrafung auf Gog und Magog, der hier stattfindet.
Right.
Amen.
And the point I want to make is that there is a space to repent.
Es gibt ein Zeit, Buße zu tun.
Now, nobody standing before the kings here or the rest of it. Who's, what's this illustration? It's for whose benefit?
So, keiner steht hier vor den Königen in diesem Flaktal. Also diese Darstellung ist für wessen Vorteil?
For our benefit, right?
Für unsere Vorteil.
And many people in this movement have left, right?
Viele Menschen in dieser Bewegung haben die Bewegung verlassen.
So when this comes true, what will they then have?
So wenn dies stattfindet, was werden sie denn haben?
A space to repent, right?
Zeit, um Buße zu tun.
Because they will have no justification for delivering us up there because of this, right?
Sie werden keine Rechtfertigung haben, uns hier auszuliefern wegen das, was hier passiert.
Okay, and when they do this, their probation will close immediately.
Deren Gnadentür wird sofort zugehen.
Okay. Okay, maybe I have to think about that.
So vielleicht musste ich darüber nachdenken.
Okay, but here this would be the seventh plague. This would be this on the bigger one, right?
So auf den größeren Ebene.
Okay. So when you get here,
wenn Sie hier ankommen,
there's a group that receives the punishment, right?
Es gibt eine Gruppe, die Bestrafung erhält.
Yes.
Amen.
But there'll still be a space to repent for another group who were not so guilty.
So right? Diese Zeit hier, es wird hier drin eine Zeit für eine weitere Gruppe, um Buße zu tun, die nicht so schuldig war.
Right.
Amen.
And then John begins to preach. Right?
Und dann fängt an Johannes zu predigen.
And there's a space to repent. What's John's message?
Es gibt eine Zeit, Buße zu tun. Was ist die Botschaft von Johannes?
Repent.
Tut Buße.
What was the message of Christ at his baptism?
Was war die Botschaft von Christi zu seiner Taufe?
Repent.
Tut right? Buße.
Okay, so I'm open to look at this closer, but the point that I believe the Lord wants to show us by bringing this to pass.
Also ich bin offen, dies näher anzuschauen. Aber der Punkt, die ich denke, dass der Herr möchte, dass wir sehen, ist,
by bringing this to pass, he proves who has the truth, right?
Indem dass er dies zustande bringt an diesem Punkt, er beweist, wer die Wahrheit hat.
And therefore, those people that go and do this evil work here will have no justification for doing it.
Und deswegen diejenigen, die diese böse Werk hier vollbringen, werden keine Rechtfertigung haben, es zu tätigen.
When they reject the exceeding bright light here,
they
will get the punishment right here.
Wenn sie das äußerst helles Licht hier verwerfen, sie werden die gerechte Bestrafung hier erhalten.
Right.
Amen.
Principles, and you can see that there might be some room for some things not understood, but I'm open for that.
So Prinzipien eben, und wir konnten sehen, dass es vielleicht Bewegung gibt oder Raum gibt eben, um andere Sachen völliger auszulegen. Ich bin dafür offen.
Right.
Amen.
Okay, need to look at it closer, but nonetheless, this point is not just to increase our faith, which it will do, right?
So, ich bin dafür offen, aber wir müssen das näher anschauen. Aber dieser Punkt ist nicht nur da, um unsere Glaube zu erweitern, und es werde das eben tun.
But it should already begin bringing people to repentance.
Aber es sollte auch noch bereits Menschen zur Buße bringen.
Okay. Shall we close with prayer?
Sollen wir mit Gebet schließen?